decided that 9-to-5 job is not my cup of tea. Initially, we had lots of delivery issues because we were very new to it. I learned that you have to be independent. You should not depend on anybody.
Hello, beautiful people. Welcome to Reach Her Podcast. We hear you, and this is the platform for all budding women from various aspects of life. This is Madhumati here along with you to host our guest today, the very beautiful Kritika Ramani. We know her from Big Boss, but other than that, she's more than that. She is into entrepreneurship, where she has a brand called The Hazel Avenue, and she also does modeling. So let's welcome her. Welcome, Kritika.
Hi, everybody.
Hi.
Good morning.
Good morning. How are you doing?
How's your day?
Everything?
Yeah, I'm good. Yeah, good, good.
How's this lockdown going? How's the situation there?
Actually, we've been facing quite a tough time here because a couple of days there was a COVID positive patient nearby my home. So yesterday they came for checking and all. So it's really tough. So we are completely locked inside our house. We cannot step out.
Exactly.
So we are following all the safety measures.
So tell us about your brand, Kritika, about Hazel Avenue.
Okay. So this is completely my sister's idea. So we actually both sat together. We brainstormed lots of ideas and we googled many of the online sites. We came up with clothing brand because clothing, it's never out of trend, right? So it's always into it's on trend. I was looking at number of options, and me and my sister brainstormed number of things. She guided me a lot of things.
So this is Hazel Avenue.
Yes. So I've always had passion on starting up my own business. So we started exploring a lot of options. Like, we also had an idea of starting up a food business also. But still, as I said earlier, fashion never go out of trend, right? So we decided and we freezed into this fashion.
So
that's how Hazel Avenue started.
Yeah, and you and your sister, like, both the brains in this project. So both of you into modeling, so you felt this was more appealing to you, right?
Yes.
Now you started this business and it's a new business, right? Like, you were also new and things are going out. And how is it going now? And provided this COVID situation also, how are you keeping up?
So now you can see, right, many of the people, we sit at home and we order things online. That's how we decided on Hazel Avenue to start on an online platform. So during this COVID situation, luckily it has been a good sales and we have very much, it has come out really well.
That is really nice, because not many companies, we start in one environment and suddenly when the market changes, it is lucky that turns out to be an advantage for us. So apart from this entrepreneurship and apart from this business, tell us about your modeling, interest in modeling. Were you interested in it since a young age, or eventually you started liking it, or how would it go?
No, I actually, in my life, I never plan anything. It just happens. So what happened was, when I entered Big Boss, I was recognized. I didn't expect the kind of reception I got. So many people started to see my profile on Instagram and other social media. So that's when I decided to post professional pictures. Okay. So many people started approaching me for photo shoots and branding promotions. So, and I was jobless at that time. So I decided to make myself,
take advantage of the opportunity that is coming.
Yes, exactly. So I wanted to keep myself occupied. So that's when I started this modeling, and it came out as usual. As
out.
I wished, it came out. Yeah. It has added more advantage for my own clothing brand. So
yeah, exactly. And now you can you have your own face as your brand, and you have your sister support also. And being the branding of that, being, I mean, you have this outfits and that is already in trend. And when people know your face, it is just an added advantage to you, right?
Yeah, yeah. So modeling is not planned. That's my answer for this question.
So your plan was to start a business. So business was on your mind since before.
Yes, yes. When I was working also, I decided that 9-to-5 job is not my cup of tea. Okay. So that's... the job was really boring and it was a mechanical life day to day. So the job didn't excite me very much. So that's when I decided to start something which I want to do with some passion and love.
So how do you feel about being a part of, I mean, being starting a business and since 9-to-5 job, you didn't like it and it was not exciting. And how was the Hazel Avenue? How do you feel about that?
See, having your own business is like having a lot of advantage. You can start whenever you want and you can, like, to be very frank, I take care of this business. I reply to certain clients and I start, there's no timing at all, to be very frank. You can start at any time. So, but job, it's totally different, right? Some people will call us, you have to be available at that time.
Yeah, you are always answerable to somebody.
Yes. So, basically, I'm liking this more. This is my shop. I can start whenever I want, preferably. So, yeah. So, whenever I want, I can start. Whenever I can want, I can close like that.
But by doing that, don't you think you should be answerable to the clients? Because when you, some, there are, yes, this is one thought that entrepreneurs have. Like, you are not answerable to anybody. You can do what you want. There is another school of thought saying you still feel very responsible to your clients. You need to be there when they need you and you need to answer to them properly. So what do you feel about the responsibility side of it?
Yes. So I'll tell you an example. So sometimes, luckily, we don't have many of the customers saying the dress don't fit. One or two we have, right? So that time, I feel I take a lot of responsibility from my side. So I do immediate exchange, and if they want even refund also, I try to just feel their concern and I just immediately respond. So there are certain things like that. And then if they want to deliver this product by this date, so I take the responsibility and I deliver it like that.
So you focus your you instead of being called instead of calling it an answerable situation, you take it as your responsibility, and since you like it, it doesn't feel like a burden to you, right?
Yes, yes, exactly.
So it all matters about the interest. Like if you do it, you like it, and you do it without effort, right?
That's a saying, right? When you do what you do, when you love what you do, you are never working.
Yeah,
so
exactly.
That's the thing I follow.
Yeah. So now that you've started off and things are getting better, how do you think of, what are your aims and what are the new things that you want to bring into the Hazel Avenue? How are you trying to scale up or what are your future plans about this?
So yeah, we are planning to start a website, but not anytime soon. And then after a few years, we will launch an application on Play Store. And so that's the long-term goal. And then we are trying to bring in lots of fashion, like Korean fashion. And then we are fully into Western clothes only. So we want everybody to
try out new
access this yes so it should be available easily available for the all this fashion, right? You have seen you must have seen in Korean dramas those Korean fashion,
they're so cute mini skirt and don't know where to get it, so that is one problem that you're addressing, right?
Yes so I'm concentrating on that part,
so
we're working on it.
That's nice. I hope you scale up and then you bring out many trends, because in India especially and specifically in South India, we are not, I mean, there are places where you get nice clothes and you can try out new trends, but experimenting with clothes, like you bring in some other cultures dresses and experimenting and availability of such places is also very less. So I hope you answer all those problems and you bring out new trends in the market.
We'll definitely keep up the expectations. I'm sure about it.
While this being about your business, tell us about your modeling. Like, what are your projects that you're working on? Are you collaborating with anybody? And how is it going? Like, what is the progress?
So as I said earlier, modeling is not my, I didn't plan it. So it just happened. So I decided to be model for my own brand. Yeah. So maybe if I get any opportunities, I will definitely work on for other brands also. So currently I'm not working for any brands or promotion. If I get any opportunity, I'll definitely do.
Yeah, as of now you're focused
on
Yes. So, what are your interests or hobbies apart from this business and modeling? What are your other interests, Kritika?
So, I play chess. So, I'm a national level player. So, I always relate chess with my life because one wrong move goes everything. It collapses everything, right? So, chess is my favorite game. Whenever I get bored, even in this quarantine, me and my sister always we play chess only. We challenge each other and we play.
Like, since when did you start playing this chess? Like, if you are a national player, then you should have started it earlier, right?
From standard standard. Started playing.
Did you start playing? Like, did you get trained because? You take dancers or athletes or any players, they get trained mostly. So for chess, how was it? Did you learn it on your own or did you go to classes or how was it?
No. I got properly trained. My master name was Sundara Master. He used to come home. He used to train me. He was charging 500 rupees per class. He used to come home and he used to take classes and he used to take me for the tournaments also.
Okay.
So that's how I started playing chess.
So,
schools also have one zonal tournament and in college I've played lots of, and in office also I have certificates also.
That's nice.
That's how I started playing chess.
Because they say, like, when you're even when we go to job interviews, they ask about our interests, your, and how we relate our hobbies to the work that we are going to do. So that is what I, that being in chess, a chess player, that would have surely helped you in your business also, as you already told. So that is why I was curious about what else hobbies do you have? Because as an entrepreneur, you will have to have other habits that will help you be, perform well in your business and all these things. When you started off, like after your education or after your first job or anything, after, when you first started, they say the beginning is the hardest part in everything. So how hard was it? Was it hard for you? And how was the situation then? When you started modeling or business?
Okay. For first, I'll start with modeling thing. Okay. The hardest thing was getting up early was very difficult task for me.
Okay.
But then I enjoyed because I chose this modeling part. So I enjoyed. I went and then standing in the, under the light, I'm photophobic. I don't like those strong lights.
Yes.
So I don't like that. So that was difficult for me. But yeah, then I enjoyed posing because I'm very addicted to the selfies and all. So that was nice.
Okay.
I enjoyed. And then for business, initially we had lots of delivery issues because we were very new to it. We didn't know how to deliver for abroad and all. We had lots of queries. Mm-hmm. But then my sister's friend, she is the owner of another clothing brand. She helped us and guided us a lot of things. She came home. She took initiative. She did deliveries and all. So, yeah. So, I must thank her. So, I'll take this opportunity to thank her. If I can mention her name, sure. I'll just... her name is Divya. So, thank you so much, Akka. Without you, Hazel Avenue is just nothing, I would say. Thank you so much.
That is nice that you use opportunities to show your gratitude. And that is totally worth it because I have seen many people trying to start business like that field, though it is a very new field for them. seeking help is very difficult. So if people are getting help, that is really something to be appreciated. Just give me a minute, 1 minute. Yeah. So talking about how were the challenges and all these things, can you recall any moment or any situation where you felt like, this is not happening, this I never expected this to be so tough, and finally you got over it? Any such moments?
I would just say this COVID situation, it is very difficult to restock things from abroad. So we are sourcing from other countries our clothes, so it's very 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 difficult. So that's when I spoke to my sister, is it really happening, are we still on the trend or so I spoke with my sister regarding that 2 months ago, I guess. So we started in March, so I don't easily give up. So I was a little worried because it's not happening right. So I was just asking my sister help. She said, no, this situation is not permanent. It will, we will overcome that. So don't worry about that. So I'll talk to my other friends. We'll get clothes from Mumbai or Lucknow or Jaipur. So initially, for this temporary, we can source. Time being, you can just, they say, right, if you don't have idli, you have to do upma and give like that, something like that.
I get it. For time, so people have
it
to
was
do.
Funny. Yeah, you have to do it. So you can't quit. She told me that you can't quit. You have to come up in your life. So this is just temporary. So that's when I decided and I asked my sister's guidance. She helped me through that. So no problem.
Yeah.
We overcome. So
that is nice, because in any entrepreneurial journey or anything you start, initially the time is very difficult. You need to have to, I mean, you know, overcome and all these things have to happen. So apart from all these things, I observe that you like traveling a lot also.
Every year we plan a vacation with my sister, especially. She's my best friend. So I just torture her. I'll ask her, we have to go to somewhere of the city. I mean, somewhere of the world, some part of the world we have to go. So she takes me. So this year we plan to go to Bali, but it's okay. I thank God that we are all are safe at home.
Yeah.
So I'm not complaining. I'm just saying.
That's a positive note, because most of us, because I also had a lot of plans and everything got ruined because of this one whole year is gone, right? So it's nice that you're thanking God you're safe.
Yeah.
Going there and being caught and all these things.
Yes.
So how did was there any contribution that traveling did, like maybe when we go to different places, we explore new cultures and we get to know many things, right? So were there anything like that? Any new thing you learned?
I would say last year we went to Thailand. So I decided, I'm like, I eat on time. Okay. So breakfast, lunch and dinner, it should be on time, on table. Yeah. If I miss any one of that, I get little cranky. Okay. I get so cranky that I started torturing my sister during the vacation. So I learned that you have to be independent. You should not depend on anybody. So I'm a pure vegetarian, right? So in Thailand, you don't get any pure veg food over there. So I saw a live crocodile was roasting. So my sister is not like that. She eats, even in non-veg hotel, she eats veg. Okay. I'm not like that. I don't eat at all because I'm not adaptable like that.
You're not comfortable with that.
I'm not comfortable with that because I think that they fry on the same
pan,
oil and give it. So that too in Thailand, after seeing the crocodile, I couldn't eat anything. So my sister got pissed. She was like, we are on vacation. You don't expect food on time. So I went to a shop. I went to a shop. I got a bread and Nutella. So I decided that I should not depend on anybody for food. And you should not disturb anybody.
Yeah.
You have to enjoy the moment, right? You're just spoiling. I thought that I was just spoiling the vacation just because for one food and stuff. So I started adjusting myself. That's what I'm coming to.
You need to. Yeah, adaptability is very important, right?
Yes. You have to adjust to the situation. So my sister was like, okay, fine. Finally, you got a solution. okay, get lost.
So, for all this throughout your life, maybe in career or in any other interests of yours, what or who was your inspiration? Like, there must be something at some point you felt, I want to be like this thing, you know. Who was it?
My biggest inspiration from the childhood, I would say Jayalalitha ma'am. Because my mom always says, you're also the same star and the same sunshine. And
oh, I'd be like, wow. I was the same always sunshine and star.
Okay. Same Maga Rasi Simha Nakshatram.
Yeah, the same thing.
So I'll be like, wow. So you always get those thing, right? That's, that star feel and the celebrity feel.
Yeah.
So that's when I decided, I mean, I thought Jayalalitha ma'am is so, she was so independent, she was so strong. She fought with many men and she stood alone. She never feared for anything, right? She never feared for anything. So I learned, I see her interviews, I get so inspired and I admire her so much. I just love her.
Yeah, she is a great inspiration because throughout the struggles and we all see them in one angle, but their life itself is totally different behind the camera. So throughout all those struggles, she's been such a person. So she's no wonder a great inspiration to all of us. So let's think of a hypothetical situation. Now, imagine you get a chance or you get a boon where you can choose one advantage that nobody else can have. Like you are, even if others have, you are the best in whatever you're doing. What would that benefit that you would ask for? What is that unfair advantage that you would ask?
To never grow old. I want to be young as 16 years.
Okay.
Maybe
16 or 20
and then 16 and like two what to say, ayo, greedy, I'm too greedy, so 16 okay. Would be fine, and then to eat, and you should not put on weight, you can eat anything and you don't worry about the calories.
Everybody has, no?
Yeah, so you can have anything but you don't worry about the calories. So that's the thing.
Okay. If you get a chance to go back in time, okay. So which part of your life would you go back?
I don't want to turn back my past. I never want to go back at all. Because I want to march forward. I don't want to go back.
That's nice. That's because most of us want to relive the moments, but we forget that we have crossed so long. You were about to say something.
I've learned many things in my past, so I had breakups and I don't want to talk about my personal life, but still I learned many things that you have to be independent, you have to be very strong, you should not depend on anybody for your own happiness. So when I think about those situations at this time, I feel so stupid, I feel so kiddish and now I'm matured enough that I can handle my own situation, that I don't depend for anybody for my happiness. And yeah, so somebody tells or talks about their past, I like, what's the past? I don't want to talk about my past.
It's okay, but you don't want to go back to your past, but you are what you are today because of that past. So we'll just take the lessons and go forward, as you said. We'll just keep marching forward. So
true. Yeah. I would agree that.
What are the, somebody comes and asks you for any advice, like they're struggling and they want to do something for their own or anything like that, what would your advice be to them?
So if you're starting, even if it's a small or a big business, you have to work hard first thing. You have to put on your full efforts. Even if you have only 10 rupees and you expect 100 rupees, it's okay. If you don't get that, it's fine. Eventually, it's fine, I would say. So you have to give your full efforts and work hard on that. Main thing, you should not give up easily. So I learned that from my sister, because when I told you, right, when I had the situation of difficulty in restocking stuff, my sister said, you should not give up. You have to wait. You have to be very, very patient. You have to be very patient. And then, so I would say that I would advise them that you have to work hard, you have to be very patient, and then don't be like demotivated just because you don't get any profit. Eventually you will grow up within the time, I would say.
Yeah. So thank you so much, Kritika. That was a real nice time that we had with you. I hope for your modeling career and your business to grow high enough that all new trends come to South India soon, and we all get to explore a lot of things. So thank you for your time and for sharing your experience with us.
It was lovely talking to you, Madhu. Thank you so much. Have a good day.
Thank you. So to the viewers now, thank you for your time. Thank you for staying with us. Stay tuned till the next episode. Until then, this is Madhumati signing off from Reach Her Podcast. We hear you, and this is a platform for all budding women out there. Thank you.
Reach Skyline. Embrace digital.